Welcome to another adventure of Lumpy Thumb. We're going to do kind of several videos today. The first one is in kind of an answer across a couple, three different Facebook pages that I'm on. People are always asking, how do you come up with camp meals? People are tired of having steaks, brats, and dogs all the time. So. And people's answer always is, well, just cook what you cook at home. And that's not always, feasible. That's not always easy to do. Because a lot of times you have campfires. A lot of times here in central Illinois where I live, today it rained pretty good. So anywhere that I need to go to cook a meal fast to get my family fed is going to be soggy, and it's going to be a laborious process to get a fire going. So in the interest of time, I'm going to go ahead and cook on a Coleman stove. Runs off one of the mini propane tanks. I think you can get the whole rig from Walmart probably for around 20 bucks or so. Nothing I have is really special or unique. It's a Stanley Cook pot. We have tomatoes, we got avocado, I've got some chili seasoning, which is gonna, and I guess I should tell you what I'm cooking. It's gonna be chicken roll-ups or chicken burritos or chicken tacos. However my kids decide to put it together is what they're gonna be. So we got the chili seasoning, we have cilantro, we have black beans, and we have chicken breast, and there's some limes over there, probably off camera somewhere. Well, one of the main tools I'm gonna use today is a knife that I put together from a knife kit from Self-Reliance Outfitters. This is a number 3 blank. Yes, this is the number 3 blank, and it's got winch handles on it with mosaic pins. You guys can go to the Pathfinder Learning Center Facebook page and see it for yourself. I posted really close-up pictures of this knife after I put it together. This sheath is not one that I made. I do intend on making one for this. This is just a Condor sheath for the Condor Kephart. It was just within easy reach, something to keep a guard on the blade. So I'll be using that today. So let's go ahead and get started. Flame has a nice jet engine sound to it. So this is gonna go fairly quick because this does run pretty hot. So while this is cooking, I'm gonna go ahead and do my prep. So we got just a can of black beans into the skillet. Listen to that, they're already sizzling. This thing's like a rocket. It's like cooking with jet fuel. Let's turn that down a bit because I'm afraid I'm gonna scorch my beans. All right, so again, just a couple cans of white chicken breast. These happen to be Hormel. You can use whatever you got that's local to you, or you can copy the Lumpy. That looks like a goodly amount of liquid. I'm going to dump some of this liquid out. Some of you might ask, well, Lumpy, why don't you have a wooden spoon? Well, I do. I just, this is the one I generally default to when I go camping with my children, because if I lose it, I bought it at the dollar store, I'm only out of block. So we'll get that chicken broke up. It comes in pretty good sized chunks, so we'll break it up into a little bit smaller pieces. Those beans all mixed in there nice and good. Everybody's in the pot happy and warming up. And that's really all you have to do this, because everything is already cooked. That's why this is such a great camp meal, because everything is already cooked. And really what you're doing is just warming it through in order to feed a hungry crew pretty quick. So just going to sprinkle in some of this chili seasoning. For those of you that are going to ask, this is Ray's Brand Original Seasoning. I don't remember where I got it, but it does come in a really slick metal tin. Remember, you can always add more spice, but it's hard to take it out, so I try to start a little light with my seasoning and then season to taste, bearing in mind who I'm cooking for, because they don't like their food quite as hot and spicy as Dad does. Alright, we're going to let that go ahead and go, and I'm going to get over here and start working on some veggie, some toppings prep. Again, with my Pathfinder kit knife, took it across my Diamond Stone today. Self-Reliance Outfitter ships these things to you with a wire edge on it, and it doesn't take much to bring them into hair popping sharp. I mean, I think it was like 5 passes on the coarse side and 6 or 8 passes on the fine side. And man, this thing is just crazy sharp. So I'm going to go ahead and cut up some tomatoes. I don't know if you guys can see them down here in the mess. I'm just going to dice those up. I'm going to slice up some avocado for these things and go ahead and get this cilantro all chopped up so that it goes. Man, that thing is, hang on, I got to stir again. This thing cooks so hot, I think the chicken's probably going to be ready before I'm done goofing off and talking about veggies. Back that off a little bit more. So, looks like I got to be quick about these tomatoes. Just Roma tomatoes that I picked up at the local market this morning. The tortilla shells are a mixture. I have regular tortilla shells for my children, and I have the carb conscious tortilla shells for myself. Lumpy's got to watch his carbs because I'm infected with the diabetes. That's a good little amount of tomato. I'm just going to stop with one. Get back in here and stir this. I can hear it bubbling on me. I don't want to scorch those beans or that chicken to the bottom of this pot. Give it a little taste. That's pretty good right there. I think I'm just gonna give it a little dash more of the chili seasoning and call it good, because it's got a pretty good flavor already. I don't want to overdo it. In, and then we'll go back over here to the avocado. I'm sure you guys have seen 1,000 cooking shows show you how to deal with an avocado. It's super simple. Just make an incision until you find the seed, and then just roll the knife around the seed. And then it easily splits into two halves. The riper the avocado, the easier it is to roll it, to basically just work with avocados. So we just twist the seed out, and you guys want chunks or strips?
Chunks.
Chunks. So I'm going to chunk this. The way you do that is you take your knife through the avocado. Actually, I'm going to use a dull knife to do this because I'm afraid that I'm going to go right through that skin and through my hand. So you just drag that knife straight through the avocado. Ooh, that did go through. And then turn it 90 degrees and go through it again. And that's the easiest way to make chunks out of an avocado. Makes it super simple, quick and easy. Quick, do that to the other side before I scoop them out. What you see me dangle in front of you earlier, that was a an old United States military cutlery set I just put on a carabiner so I can keep them together. They're fairly inexpensive. They're super durable because they have to put up with the abuse of the United States military. Having been in the military, I know how we are on equipment. So stainless steel, solid set. I think I got three sets for right around $20 off the bank. So that's the avocado cut into chunks. Then you just grab your spoon. Let me do some logistics here and move my tomato a little bit. Again, I'm pretty common man. The cutting board you see, if you can see it, it's dollar store cutting board. You know, anything I take camping, with the exception of very few items like my axes, I don't have a lot of money in case they get ruined or lost, so I'm not bummed out. But you can get some fairly quality stuff fairly cheap, just, you know, you guys know what you're looking at. So there's avocado chunks for, avocado. So there's avocado chunks for the bean and chicken things. You guys think an avocado tree might grow if I chuck the seed out in the woods?
Uh-huh.
You do? Got my peanut gallery working for me. Okay, I hope you guys didn't see that. There's a reason why I don't work for the Cardinals or the Cubs. Because I am not a good pitcher. So, I'm going to take some of this cilantro. And I'm just going to give it a rough chop. Just so I can sprinkle it on the burritos. For those of you that don't like cilantro, because I know that there is a genetic factor that makes some people taste cilantro as soap, I am sorry for you people. I really am, because cilantro is, I love it. This stuff is great. But I also know what soap tastes like, because, well, I'm of an age where moms used to put soap in your mouth when you said some certain things. So we're going to give the wildlife some of that cilantro just in case they want to come by later and have some of our scraps. Because this place is pretty loaded with raccoons and possums and all sorts of, you know, Midwest wildlife. They don't allow trapping or hunting out here, so they do get rather prolific. All right, so that's all of our stuff chopped up. Of course, there's always more. If I need to come back and get it later, I can make more. Give our beans and chicken another stir, because I can just hear it simmering away. This stuff is going crazy. And some of you, taco and burrito and enchilada, fajitas even, aficionados are asking, Lumpy, how do you get your tortillas warm? We'll look into that right after this. See you in a little bit when this is done cooking. Hello friends, we're back. This is Lumpy Thumb. Cooking campfire meals. This chicken and beans, it's cooked down pretty good. It's ready to come off. And for those of you that were asking the computer screen, phone screen, tablet, whatever you happen to be watching me on, those of you who are asking your screens, well, how does he get the tortillas warm? Well, I'm here to show you. So I'm going to go ahead and take this off and set it to the side. The way I get the tortillas warm, usually I do this over a coals, over a campfire. Or I do it off of coals on a grill. So I'm not real sure how it's going to work on this, but it should work just fine. What I've got here are just 2 88-cent pie pans from Walmart. Just put one over the burner, and we'll put Dad's. Good God, that thing's already smoking. We'll put Dad's tortillas in there. Of course, I left my tongs at home too, so Dad's gonna have to use a super. Lumpy's gonna use the lumpy tongs. So we just let that get some warm on it. Give it a flip. And that sucker is ready to come out. Let's see here what I got. How many do you want? Three. Again, you're not looking to cook these tortillas, they're already cooked. You're just looking to give them a little bit of warmth so that they roll easy without tearing. Of course, Lumpy had everything ready except the kids' tortillas. All right, easy bits. Such a dick. And just keep doing your tortillas like this until you've got the amount that you want warmed, and then I'll show you what to do after that to keep them warm. Back in a minute. Okay, friends, back for the last time. I think, of course, if anybody's been following Lumpy for any time at all, Lumpy forgets things. This time, Lumpy forgot his plates. So I was going to demonstrate to you how to keep these tortillas warm quick. So you get the 2 pie plates. Once you get all your tortillas warm, bam, tortilla warmer. But since I forgot plates, now the tortilla warmers have to become plates for my kids will get them. I don't deserve a plate because I forgot them. So I'm going to go ahead and quick get one of these things loaded up. I usually start with the youngest first because she's the most inconsolable if I don't get her started. So take, you know, however big of a spoonful you want of this stuff. Put it down there on your tortilla. Give it a little sprinkle of cilantro. Tomato. Avocado, a few drips of lime juice, and top it off with some, this here's Mexican sour cream. It's a Lala brand. It's Mexican style sour cream, rich and creamy. I actually like this stuff better than the American style sour creams since I've started using it. I get it at Save-A-Lot, but you can definitely use regular sour cream. Those of you that watch that are opposed to sour cream, plain Greek yogurt works fine. All that stuff. So, as you can see, beautiful looking lump of stuff on the side of that tortilla. I'm going to give it a fold at the bottom, fold in the middle, roll it up, and feed it to my youngest Savage.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks everyone for joining Lumpy Thumb. Just a different look at how to cook other things, you know. Just so you know that when you're cooking camp meals, you're not stuck with steak, you know, potatoes wrapped in foil, brats and dogs. I mean, so thank you for joining me. If you would, go ahead and like my videos so that this content can reach more people. And if you would, I would appreciate it if you'd subscribe to my channel. And I will bring you some more stuff later on. Thank you all. You gotta love a lumpy. See you later.